So with that, ladies and gentlemen, without taking any more time, let me quickly move on to the next special address. Mr. Himanshu Bakshi, Managing Director, Danone India, speaks on the topic of nudging India to eat healthy. Now, this is an interesting one. I'll hand over to Himanshu to take you through the journey.
All right. Thank you so much, Tavin. What an interesting session. You know, I was not there for the entire bit, but yes, I did hear about, you know, the currency bit and, you know, and now we're going to talk about the real wealth, you know, which is health, as we all talk about it, and a very important topic to address, you know, for us in India. Really glad to be here to have this discussion. I'll be taking you through a few slides and then maybe we can have a larger discussion around it. So, you know, we're talking about this interesting topic, which is really about nudging India to eat healthy. And this is absolutely in line with what we do at Danone, you know, especially in India, to really try and inculcate, you know, these healthy eating habits in people. You know, it's really important we do that right now and address certain areas, you know, which are there of concern for us, you know, as Indians. You know, if you really look at the landscape today, when it comes to the health status of most Indians, it is quite worrisome. You know, there have been a lot of talks around, you know, health, wellness, you know, lifestyle diseases. But when you really look at data, when you really look at numbers, you know, some of them are really shocking facts, you know, that come to the table. Just a few of them that I've just put on screen, you know, for all of us to see, you know, look at the lifestyle diseases that we're going through, you know, 20% plus people having cholesterol, India now becoming the diabetes capital of the world, 40 million plus, a lot of issues that we see on cardiovascular diseases, hypertension. While these are all, you know, diseases that impact, you know, us physically, I think the input is important. You know, what we eat really defines, you know, what is going to happen to us. So a few stats, if you really look at the screen, you know, for example, 70% plus having insufficient physical activity, and that's not great. 91% of people in India having protein deficient diets. And I think we always have a lot of assumptions and myths in our mind when we say that, you know, we are eating very well. You know, most of my diet that I eat, you know, the Indian thali, yes, of course, it's pretty good. But is it what your body really requires? And these are times when we forget that there are large-scale deficiencies, you know, we need to cater to. And I think it's the responsibility of food organizations, you know, companies, brands, to bring all of these out in the open, address them, and really make these very meaningful journeys, you know, for the consumers in the future. Yes, there are profit objectives. You know, every organization, every brand will want to deliver, you know, on their objective of revenue and profit. But the question is that enough? As a brand, is that what you really want to deliver? I think what I feel and, you know, what's the large thinking here at Danone is very clear. It's not only about profits. It's not only about, you know, getting your top line in. What's really important is how can you as an organization, how can you as a brand play a very positive role and impact people's lives positively? If you can have healthier people out there, I think that's what the real success looks like, you know, to us. And that's where it comes to, you know, how we see, you know, a brand versus a stand. You know, a brand can be the what, which really talks about what will the brand answer. But I think what's important is the why behind it. Why is the brand there? Why is the brand existing? What's the larger scope that the brand wants to cover? I think unless this is clear, we're not going in the right direction. You know, when we talk about brands, you always talk about points of difference. You know, how is my brand better than you? How is my brand better than the category leader? But I think it's important brands have a point of view. A market share, you know, fight is something that will always happen. But what is it that the brand stands for? What is it that the organization stands for? I think that is something that's really important to define right at the beginning, you know, before you start on this journey with the consumer. You know, there are a lot of points here. I won't, you know, go with each one of them, but I think the point which I want to really make is, you know, as a brand, you know, it's very easy to play tactically. It's very easy to start thinking of brand as a property, which will go out there, you know, try and answer some consumer needs, you know, and get your profit out of there. I think brands need to stand for something. Brands need to have a clear purpose, the bank needs to answer something really big for the society. And unless, you know, any brand does that, I think there is no real meaning of a brand being there out there in the market. I think these are thoughts which, you know, resonate with us quite a bit when we have our discussions internally at Danone. It's important that I set this context before I really tell you, you know, what we've been doing so far. And I'll pick up a couple of examples to really showcase, you know, what we've done so far and what our journey has been. So let me start with the mission, you know, that we have at Danone. And then it's very important that we spend time on this. You know, it's bringing health through food to as many people as possible. You know, I think the key words to see out there are health and food. We don't just see food as something which is there to fill people's stomach. We don't just see food as something which will give you satiety versus hunger. I think we're talking about a larger platform. I think whatever offering that comes from Danone in India, whatever offering that comes from our portfolio should be addressing a strong health need. And unless, you know, it gives a tick mark on that, I don't think we'll be launching any brand, you know, in the future. So most of our products and whatever we have on the portfolio today is completely in line, you know, with the mission that we have, which is to bring health through food to as many people and, of course, as many Indians as possible. And because of that, we do have, you know, our strategy and a lot of commitments that we make as an organization. You know, for us, as I said, success is not only, you know, growing very good on top line, you know, getting great profits on the business, but really push people or nudge people to adopt healthy eating and drinking habits. And I think that's the role that we intend to play in India. And that's what we've been doing globally. And it's a step by step process. It doesn't happen overnight. I think the first thing that we need to convince people or offer people is better quality products. I think whatever we have on the portfolio today, we need to continuously improve the nutritional quality of the brand so that people get food which is the most nutritious, you know, which is the most innovative new technology and which makes their life a lot better than what it is. It's also about being very local. You know, there are a lot of local nuances that are there, a lot of local benefits that brands have. And I think it's important to recognize, you know, these needs. At the end of the day, I think it's really about being proud of the portfolio that you offer to people. Something that I can be proud of to sell, something that I will give my family to have, something I will have. And that's, you know, in a way is the epitome of success that I see personally, you know, for us at Danone. So better products, I think that's the first basic fundamental, you know, we talk about. The second one is, you know, better choices. When it comes to food, I think India is one geography which is, you know, unique when it comes to the choices that we have. The question is, can we drive people to healthy choices? You know, there's always this fight between taste versus health. And we've had many discussions around it in terms of, you know, what's healthy. Can healthy be tasty? I think that's where the role of innovation comes in. And we call it innovation, you know, which is innovation in India. I think there is an opportunity definitely, you know, to give people options, you know, through a lot of innovation. Communicate, you know, to people in a way that they get better choices to make. You know, at the end of the day, what's important, you know, I spoke about certain statistics in the past. If we can have a positive impact on people's diet, on people's consumption, and have their quality of life being better, I think that's what we as a food company want. And that's something that we're going to keep promoting, which will, of course, help people adopt it, you know, help people nudge, you know, their choices more towards, you know, healthier options that are available. But I think the whole responsibility and obligation, you know, lies with companies like ours, you know, to start this whole journey, to start this movement, to make sure that people follow. If you look at our portfolio, you know, you would have seen most of these brands, you know, in the market, you know, brands like Proteinx are legacy brands in the Indian market. Almost 100% of our portfolio lies in health today. So, you know, while we talk about it, we make sure we deliver on it. So whatever we're going to launch in India, whatever we have launched so far in India, has always been extremely healthy. And that's the choice that we want people to have. Whenever they talk about Danone, whenever they talk about nutrition, they should know that anything that's coming out of this organization will always follow health. So nutrition for all is what we talk about. And all our portfolios, even in the future, and some very exciting launches that are going to happen, are going to fall in the same line of health for people. I'll just share an example of, you know, one of the agendas that we have picked up, you know, as an organization. And it's an important agenda to address. Around 4 years back, you know, there was a big survey that happened, which showed that more than 70% of Indian diets are protein deficient. And protein is one of the key building blocks for each one of us. I think there are a lot of myths that are associated with protein. A lot of people think they're getting adequate protein. But I think protein deficiency is a big agenda that we need to address. And not only us as Danone, but I think all of us, you know, together need to address this. Because unless we do that, you know, protein deficiency leads to a lot of issues. And that's something we want to address. So the last 5 years, you know, we've been doing a lot of work, you know, to make sure we educate people, you know, we work with stakeholders. We work with a lot of agencies to make sure there is enough noise around the fact that people are made aware that there is lack of protein in their diet. You know, they need to look at this extremely seriously. And this is something that, you know, should in a way help us in the future if this improves. Because once this improves, we know that you're going to have a better physical life, and a better physical life means better quality of life. So it's very important to address this. And we at Danone have picked up this as, you know, one of the core areas that we want to work. We have been working on it, and something that we'll keep on working, you know, in the future. Now, what do we do about it? You know, one is just talking about this whole protein deficiency bit. But what do we need to do, and what have we done so far to make sure that there is enough noise, you know, around it? I think there are three ways that I look at it. You know, the first one is as a responsible food organization, we need to give better products to people. Unless you do that, you know, you're not really, you know, living up to the mission that you have. And this is 100% our responsibility. So I think better products. The second one is the power of partnerships. You know, one company alone cannot, you know, take this entire journey forward. It has to be a holistic approach, you know, so stakeholders are important, and a joint stakeholder movement, you know, which means companies, which means, you know, HCPs, which means retail, which means credible industry bodies. We all need to come together to make enough noise around it to make sure that this is heard. And the third one is more to do with consumers. You know, how do they get to know? As I said in the beginning, most of us don't even know we are having lack of protein in our diet. So we worked on certain tools and services which will help people understand, you know, their deficiency, and which will help them, you know, make the right choice in terms of how much they should be having in terms of protein. So the first one, better products. We need to continuously improve. We need to continuously make our brands more healthier. We need to continuously innovate to make sure whatever we are offering is impacting lives positively. And so the brand that we have, ProteinX, you know, we've continuously improved its nutritional profile year on year. You know, last year we had this whole discussion around, you know, sugar being a big menace, you know, and with the Indian population racing towards diabetics, you know, having sugar on the portfolio was not the right option. So we did work around it. Now the entire portfolio is zero sugar, you know, which makes the product even more healthier for people. So you're not only getting protein, but you're also saving yourself from the menace, you know, of sugar on the portfolio. So this is just one of the examples, but even on the overall nutritional profile, you know, we keep on working so that people get better options, you know, for the future. The second is power of partnerships. You know, so we work very closely with, you know, the FSSAI. You know, they have the Eat Right India movement, and we were amongst the first few organizations to sign up on that, which is a pledge you know, to make sure that whatever comes from our portfolio is healthy. We also work very closely with CII, which is a very credible body, to really talk about protein and the protein adequacy that's required. We are right now in the midst of the protein week. Now, it's an annual affair. Doesn't mean that we don't talk about protein the entire year, but this is one special week, you know, where we make heightened noise around protein. And we come together with all these stakeholders to make huge, you know, communication around the need of protein so that people are sensitized on its need. The impact has been quite good. You know, we've reached more than 100 million people so far. Yes, when you look at the scale of India, you know, still a lot needs to be done. But I think we are on the right track. We are in the right direction, you know, to make sure we bring this message going forward. And the last one is on the tools. Now, as I said, how do you really know or how do you assess there is a problem? I think most people in India don't have the tools to assess it. So we started this whole thing around the immunonutrient calculator. It's available on our website, proteinx.com. It's a free of cost calculator that you can use. You know, you just have to key in the daily diets that you have and you'll find out what key deficiencies you have in your diet, not only protein, but all macro and micronutrients. I think once people see that, you know, once people get assessed, that's when they really realize, you know, that there is a problem in the diet and they need to take corrective action. So I think as brands, as companies, we also need to be enablers, you know, for them. It's not only just going to them with an ad campaign and telling them, oh my God, it's really great. Please choose us. But I think you have to be a partner in this journey. You have to be enablers to them so that they can understand, they can assess what's really happening around their diets and finally take, you know, corrective action around that. So this is what we've done on, you know, ProteinX as a brand. You know, we've been doing it continuously. We are seeing some excellent results in terms of protein awareness, you know, going up. Now, which is, as I said, completely in line with the topic that we had today, which is nudging people to have, you know, to eat healthy, to have healthier choices. You know, that's something we really want to do. And yeah, finally, I think it's important that, you know, all stakeholders come together on this one. You know, it's not one company alone who can make a big impact. You know, it's all stakeholders. You know, the more we talk about it, the more we create a dialogue around it, you know, through key stakeholders, the more people will be aware. So they assess themselves, they get awareness, and finally they take action. I think if we can do that, I'm sure the nutritional profiles or the health profiles of people in India will be much better and their quality of life is much better. And I think that's one commitment that I, you know, take forward as, you know, the managing director of Danone, that we will continue to keep working on it. We will make sure we keep giving you healthier nutritional choices and really get India to a great state. Thank you very much.
Thank you. Thank you, Mr. Bakshi. So that was Himanshu Bakshi, Managing Director of Danone India, talking to us, and we really appreciate your time and joining us. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Robin. Appreciate it.